you remember what is the word hallelujah? What is the word hallelujah stand for? Say praise. Shout a shout to Yahweh. Hallelujah. Yah stands for Yahweh. So a shout of praise to Yahweh. And when you are shouting to Yahweh, it's not this hallelujah. It means it's not the one that is silent, it's the one that is loud.
Glory belongs to you. in our life, in our soul, in our spirit, Lord. You discern it. You discern it. There is none like you. You are the I am that I am. You are the lily of the valley, the lion of Judah. There is none like you, our God. When your presence today to give you praise and to worship you. Thank you, Lord Father, that you are God of glory. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I'm so happy, hallelujah, to be here in the house with my family and also God's people. Amen. Hallelujah. You know, in Christ we are one. Amen. And we are family. And also I want to thank God for my sister and our mother. Hallelujah. The Lord bless you, Mama Patience. God bless you. Amen. And the children of God, also our pastor. Amen. Your pastor is a friend of mine. Hallelujah. We started this journey together. Hallelujah. And since then, I thank God for the life that you have brought me back. Amen. So the Lord will be so faithful. I will pray that His grace shall rest upon you, and the favor of God will be upon you. And I pray to every one of us that we will make it to the eternity. We should be really the main thing that we are meant. Hallelujah. That we will all see ourselves at the right side of Jesus when He comes. In Jesus' name. Father, we pray, Lord, that Lord, let your name be glorified in this that we're going to share your word in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, give us a new look and a new sight into your word, the word of grace and truth. Lord, Father, direct our path again. And Lord, let 2020 be the year of greatness in our life, the year that we will serve you more, the year that we will praise you more, the year that we are going to say that, Lord, you are our God, that will carry the cross of this Christ more in our life. Father, let your name be glorified. Lord, Father, open to us your heart today, and Lord, Father, touch each and every one as I speak the word in Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. I don't think I need to explain myself again. Thank you, Mom. I'll take it. When you'll be traveling and you have a lot of things in your head. Amen. So, amen. Church, are we alive?
Yes.
If you're alive, you hear your sound.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Do you hear my English or do you want to speak Swedish? I didn't see you respond. Hallelujah. I want you to respond. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. We have a topic that we are treating. I just want to bring the light to it, a little bit. Amen. Grace and truth. Amen. Grace and what? Truth. Please, I will give you a response. Now we'll put our way together. Grace and truth. Amen. Is what? Is Jesus. When we talk about grace and truth, we're talking about Jesus. It's not the center of the reason why we're talking about. And I want us to thank God for God, because we are the only one on earth that can talk about this grace and truth. When we talk about grace, I will talk about as there was a man in the book of Luke 19, verse 1, as well. Amen. It's called Zacchaeus. Amen. When we talk about grace, grace says to us, it does not matter who you are. Amen. Am I talking to somebody? Grace is for me and you. Amen. Grace locates me. And I pray grace will locate somebody today in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
I say grace will locate somebody today in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Can we read the book of Luke 19:1? Amen. I just want to share a little bit about the grace so that you see that it's not for, you know, some people of color. Amen. It's not just for one person. Everybody says for more.
For
more. Hallelujah. He has come for Jew and what? Gentiles. Hallelujah. Yes, let's open it. Are you there? I'm not with my Bible here. Let's read. Oh, sorry. God bless you. Then Jesus entered and passed through what? Jericho. Let's pass through, please. Now, behold, there was a man named, what's his name?
Yeah.
Everybody, please, I want us to pray. Go together. Who was a sheep tax collector? Hallelujah. This man was blessed. And at the same time, at that time, they were what we're talking about in our not like the one they take in Sweden. Amen. You know, in my country,
who say pastorate, they are people that are very
long.
They take it by force from people. Just the way they are taking it with system is failing.
Hallelujah.
That's the way pastorate are wrong. They don't take it in a loveful way. Amen. And what did he do there? Amen. To see Jesus. Amen. Jesus was, but not what? Because of his what? The crowd. For he was of what?
Short status.
That's the status that I really want to touch today. Amen. Okay. Amen. So, what did he do? And what?
Freedom.
Amen. See him, for he was going to pass through that way. Hallelujah. I want to stop there. Please, can we go back? Can we go back a little bit more? Can we go back three? Amen. And everybody, let's read together.
And he was going to see who Jesus was.
Amen. You know, life does not need. Amen. I don't think that life makes sense without Jesus. Amen. I want somebody to just have to be curious today that I want to know him. That's what I've saved my life. Amen. From destruction, from pain, from agony. Amen. The curiosity of I just want to know him. Amen. I want to see him. It's like, you know, he said, I want to see him. Amen. But he could not because of his words.
Right.
Amen. For he was a short status. Amen. A very short one. I don't know, whatever in our life today, there's a grace.
Amen.
I say there's a grace. Please, I'm talking to somebody. I come from Catholic. Hallelujah. Amen. Say there's a grace.
So
grace, find him. Grace will find you. You know, when we talk about grace, there is no limitation.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Of course, when the one that put limitation on some this and that, I do not do, I don't know how to pray, I don't know how to study, I don't know how to read Bible, all these things, amen. They are, you know, they are God that you give to yourself. But God does not work that way.
Yeah.
That's grace. Hallelujah. Grace will find you. Grace will find you. I'm talking to somebody. I say, grace will find you. Grace and truth come from where?
Jesus.
And when we talk about the truth, amen. Jesus is the truth. Amen. Am I talking to somebody? I say, Jesus is the truth. Tell your neighbor, Jesus is the truth. Are you with me? What is the truth that we're talking about? Before Jesus Christ went to the cross, there have been a lot of secret things that they used to do in synagogue. Amen. Close at the back of altar. Amen. I can give you an example. We have in this Europe today or this country today pastor that is smoking. Amen. And they are still drinking. And they will come to service. Amen. And lead the service like this in a good way. I don't know anything that happened to them except to come closer to them. Hallelujah. But when the power of the Holy Spirit is the church of God. Amen. The cutting will be told that the cutting of the tongue. Hallelujah. The truth be seen on the altar. That is the truth that me and you can come to the throne of the grace. We don't need anybody again. Hallelujah. For somebody like me is needed, pastor is needed just to share the word of God for you. But I want to tell you, I cannot take you to the throne of grace. Everybody is your right to go. Amen. And that's the truth. Everybody say that is the truth. Let's go to 2 Corinthians 12:9. Amen. I love this. Let's clap for him, brother in media. Hallelujah. Thank you so much. You make it possible. Let's clap for him. I hope you understand my African English. Hallelujah. The Lord bless you. Hallelujah. Amen. And he said to him, my grace is sufficient for you. For my strength is made perfect in what?
Weakness.
Hallelujah. You know, sometimes, one thing that makes me to be proud of Jesus is not looking for perfect us. It's not looking for perfect us. That's what makes this, you know, what we do different. We don't need any sacrifice. Amen. Just come the way you are. Amen. Hallelujah. And he said, amen, my strength is made perfect in what?
In weakness.
Hallelujah. Therefore, most I will rather be bought in what? That the power of Christ.
is it truth?
Truth.
To be sincere in your heart. That's the truth. You don't cover anything. Hallelujah. Somebody is coming back home today.
Yeah.
I said somebody is coming back home today.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. So number one, we talk about sacrifice that came through grace. Grace will find you today. Then number two, now we're talking about the truth. What is that truth? What is that fact? Hallelujah. I want to tell you, Jesus is the truth. And once you know him, please don't depend on. I don't want us to depend on pastors. Don't give your spiritual life on pastors. They are one thing like you. Hallelujah. We can make mistakes because I'm like you. Hallelujah. I don't know if I'm talking sense.
Yes.
Jesus is speaking to you.
Yes.
Amen. We're living in a generation where media is doing a lot of things. Why? Because they're talking on pastors. Hallelujah. For the truth of the Father we're talking about, hallelujah, is Jesus. Everybody say it's Jesus. Everybody say it's Jesus.
Jesus.
Say it's Jesus.
Jesus.
Alright, let's go back to Luke 19. Amen. Verse 46. Amen. 46. I want to take you to the throne of the grace and truth. Amen. Listen to me. The hands of God, they say it has been written. Am I talking to 46? Amen. And saying to them, after said and done, we'll talk about grace, the truth, all these things. Say to them, everybody say, say to them, it is written, my house is what?
House
of prayer. But you will what? You will have given it to what? It's okay. It's okay. Hallelujah. Just concentrate here. You have made it aware of things. When things happen because of our ignorance. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Church is the place of prayer. I'm taking somebody to the throne of grace today. Amen. You know, at least the Lord has given me the opportunity and the grace to take you here. Come on. Hallelujah. Let me tell you, why does no one want to live without Jesus? Amen. We carry pain, a lot of pain, a lot of questions about our living, about our marriage, about our life. Amen. What I want to tell you today, Jesus is the answer. Hallelujah. For the world to live. I don't know that song. Hallelujah. What I want to tell you, despite grace and truth, Jesus is the answer. I'm not here today to teach you. Amen. We have a teaching pastor. For the Lord has given you grace to come to you. Amen. Now we are pushing out to God 2020. As we are sitting here now, we are in a place where decision is made. And the decision is in your hand. It's in your hand. Amen. I'm also going to take a great decision. In the mighty name of Jesus. We take that in the mighty name of Jesus. Brethren, I'm here to tell you, there's a grace again.
Yeah.
You see, my grace is sufficient for you. All eyes can I want you to have a seat. Just sit down. Hallelujah. I want you to give my life to Christ. I want to make another decision. It's not about hearing about the word of God, the grace and the truth. It's not about. It's about knowing Him. One last excuse, please. When you
His word will be open to you, and the truth will be known. The Lord is calling you before His throne today. Grace and truth is Jesus. I want to give my life to Christ. I want to walk with Him. I want to move with Him. I just want you to stand with me. I want to give my life to Christ, everybody. I want to pray with you. I want to agree with you. There's a journey for you. Jesus loves you. Hallelujah. Grace is for you. My grace is sufficient for you, says the Lord. I want to give my life to Christ. All eyes closed, please. Amen. I want you to rise up on your feet. I want to pray with you. I want to give my life to Christ. Very short message today. This is the message I had so many years ago. And my life turned to Him. There's somebody here, the Lord says, I've been waiting for you. It's a day of grace and the truth. For ye shall know the truth, and the truth shall set you free. The day you accept the truth will set you free. It's not by power, not by mind, but by the Spirit, says the Lord. Hallelujah. Please, I'm waiting for you. Thank you. Hallelujah. I want you to stand up. Just stand up on your feet. I want to give my life to Christ. I want to sign a new agreement with Him. The truth and the life. I want to move in love. I want to say enough is enough. Take care of my savior. I want to agree with Him. Please, can we make a step of faith? Can we make a step of faith, please? Come on. Thank you. Can we make a step of faith, please? Let's come out. Let's come out. Hallelujah. I want to pray with you. Please make a step of faith. Amen. Come from your seat out. Don't worry. Hallelujah. Make a step of faith, please. Can somebody, can Hosha help me? Pastor, can you help me? Bring them forward. I want to pray with them. Thank you, sir. Thank you. I am beside. Don't worry, sir. Just leave him. Come to the front. Don't worry. To follow Jesus. Please come to the front. Let me pray with you. Come. I am beside. Please come, sir. Don't worry. Hallelujah. To follow Jesus. Oh, I am beside. To follow Jesus, no turning back, no turning. Are you married? I am excited to follow Jesus. I am excited, to follow Jesus. Oh, let's go last. Let's enjoy this. I am beside to follow Jesus. No turning back. No turning back. Hallelujah. Please, can you help me to come in there? My brother said, we have. Did you come in? The right decision to make. Father, we bless you. We thank you, Lord Father. Just see how we have to. We have to confess Him again. We have to confess Him again. Hallelujah. Say, Lord Jesus.
Lord Jesus.
I've come to you today. I realize I'm not there. Help me. Forgive me my sin. I want to follow. I want to. Lord, I will not look back again. Let your fire and the power of the Holy Ghost visit me for the days of my life. I will not go back from you again. Have mercy upon me and lead me into the place of your peace. Father, we thank you. We glorify your name for the souls. Father, you came for them to redeem us. I thank you, Lord Father, for your presence over today, Lord. I thank you for your presence over the church today. My Lord, my God, all of you, all daily life, Lord, in our relationship with you, all of you. Father, take over this hand, O Lord. Take them to the high place where you dwell. As from today, O Lord, I pray they will not look back again. They will not look back again. Father, I pray that, Lord, your word and your power will be with them. Father, Lord, I pray that your grace and the truth will remain with them today. Father, you will visit them today. Again, through their dream tonight, Lord, Father, you will visit them. Everything that has been taking the joy of the Lord from their life, Father, Lord, I cease to talk to it now. In the mighty name of Jesus. Whatever that has signed against their faith, Father, I break it in the mighty name of Jesus. He said, let there be light, and there was light. Father, let there be light in their life. This one, they will carry the gospel all over the world in the mighty name of Jesus. Signs and wonders will follow them. And Lord, Father, I pray, Lord, Father, the strength and the power to study your word and not to look back to come upon them. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Congratulations. Please, I would love to have your name up. We pray for you. Hallelujah. The Lord bless you. Please, can we take a note? Pastor, can you help me write your name down? God bless you, sir. I see you, you know, serving God in pain. Did you? You know, happy. But you're serving God. And we encourage you to be the new. It's a need to you. We don't use you. Yeah. When you see when you pray, you see when you pray. Amen. That's why Satan does not want you there. He's doing everything not to want you there. You've got to fight back. You've got to fight back. You belong to that. All over the world, you belong to that. That is what God has given to you. And you belong to you. The Lord my God will empower and strengthen you. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Let's love him. Hallelujah. Is that your song? Is that your song? Your God, please, is it good to pray for him? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Everybody, do you see the power of God? Amen. When the manifestation is coming, I'm stopping it. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. So this is not the will of God. Hallelujah. For this, our brother. Amen. It is well with you. Wait for sir. Kenya, oh, it is well, everybody. Oh, yes, it is well. Oh, yes, it is well. With my soul to bear. Father, we cover you with the blood of Jesus. I soak you in the blood of the Lamb. Every manipulators of the enemy, manipulation of the enemy over your life, we break. Church, help me. We break. I need your healing. I say, we pray. I see the fire of God over your life. Power aside to abort your destiny. To put you to pain for the rest of your life and be destroyed. Everybody, please, let's say amen. Say amen.
Amen.
Brother, I cover you, sir, with the blood of Jesus. He said, the stranger shall hear my voice and they shall obey. Every stranger of sickness over this body, I break it in the mighty name of Jesus. I break it in the mighty name of Jesus. The one that commands, said, let there be light, and there was light. Every darkness over this body, I command it to leave. In the mighty name of Jesus, the fire of God will visit you, sir. Yes, you will look up. I command that power now to leave you. And you look not. In the mighty name of Jesus, I command the power of God to visit you. Every gang up against your destiny, they shall be destroyed. In the mighty name of Jesus, shake off your destiny, break. In the mighty name of Jesus, it is well with you. Peace unto you. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Thank you. majority. Thank you, I love you. I wish you merry, merry, merry Christmas. Hallelujah. And happy New Year. But don't forget, heaven, eternity is our goal. See you at the top. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Naked, and God killed an animal for the first time to cover their shame. God wants to cover your shame. In fact, if only people know, church will be the place that we run into. Because a lot of people, some people today, they have gone away from God because they thought that maybe the wrong that they did or they fell, and suddenly God doesn't want to see them. God wants to embrace you and make you come to a higher place. Because it says, my grace is sufficient enough for you. If the Bible says, where there is sin, the grace is higher than sin. So where the grace of God is, sin is low. So when the grace of God is sufficient in your life, you begin to walk freely. That's why Paul was telling them, people don't understand what is this grace. Paul was telling them, said, you, he says, how can we live? How can we believe this when the grace of God is upon our life? It's not possible. So if so, not to worry. All you have to do, keep looking to Jesus. As you look to Jesus Christ, you focus on Jesus Christ. Trust me, everything concerning your life will be captured. Everything concerning your life, unless you don't look to Him. Once you keep looking on Jesus, all you need to do, gaze on Jesus Christ. Let your eyes be on Jesus Christ. Say, look unto Jesus, for He is the author and the finisher of our faith. There is no other person that can finish everything that you begin. Only Jesus Christ that can finish it for you. And that's why you saw, even in the scripture, that Zacchaeus was a rich man, tax collector. He had money and everything, but his soul was lost. And Jericho was a place that even the Israelites have condemned, because remember that Jericho was the land that even Joshua cursed in the book of Joshua chapter 6. Joshua cursed Jericho. Say, this land, nobody will be able to build this land. Anybody that will build Jericho wall and the city, the person will give two of his sons. And there was a man in the book of 1 Kings that built Jericho. The man gave two of his sons just to build Jericho. So Jericho was already a cursed city. But when Jesus came, he didn't care the city that was cursed. He walked into the city because Jesus is full of grace. And he wants to capture those that people say there is no hope for them. So Jesus is our hope. Jesus is our hope. It doesn't matter what has happened. It doesn't matter what happened to your family. It doesn't matter what happened to your life. Jesus is the hope of our glory. He's the hope of our glory. And it's our message. It's what we center on. Hallelujah. If I ask you, in the olden days, which country is the most holiest country? Which country is the most holiest country? In the olden days, the days before Jesus Christ and after, when Jesus came, which city was the, what country was the holiest country, the most sacred country? Israel. Good. And in Israel, what was the most holiest city? Jerusalem. Thank you, Shalom. And in Jerusalem, what is the most holiest place? Because there's a sacred place. Every place has sacred. What is the most sacred place in Jerusalem? Temple Mount, the temple that Solomon built. Now, in Temple Mount, what was the most holiest place?
The mercy seat.
How did you get that, boy?
Because when he was talking on the phone last, like some weeks ago, I heard him say it.